All right, let's get back to making our scene. Because we're going to be testing our students' writing and comprehension ability, and not their ability to Google test questions, let's set the scene to block mode so that they only can access the sites that we want them to. Because block mode blocks everything, we need to tell our scene what sites to let our students access. So click on Create an Exception List, enter Revolution Test as the name, and then set the type to Allow. But wait a sec, how do scenes and teacher know what parts of a website to block? Can I block just part of a website? Before we move on, let's take a moment to talk about how GoGuardian Teacher knows what to block and what to allow on a website. Basically, it classifies the URLs that you tell it to block or allow in one of three ways: a base URL, a URL with a subdomain, or a URL with a directory folder. Entering each of these will change the block or allow behavior. We'll use Wikipedia as an example. Let's take a look at three different Wikipedia URLs: a base URL, a URL with a directory folder, and a URL with a subdomain. If you block the base URL, then all of Wikipedia will be blocked for students. If you block the URL with a directory folder, then just that article and any items related to that article will be blocked. For example, blocking this Wikipedia article will also block the painting Storming of the Tuileries Palace, since it lives in the same directory. And finally, if you block a URL with a subdomain, then it will block everything on that subdomain, but not the base website. For example, blocking es.wikipedia.org will block any and all Spanish language Wikipedia articles, but not the equivalent English articles. Okay, great. Now that we know how and why scenes will block different parts of a website, let's finish up our exception list. Next, enter these three URLs one at a time in the Enter Browser URL box. Once you've added all three, click the Create List button. All right, cool. Now we've created our exception list. Next, we need to apply it to the scene. Now click on the Save Exception List tab, and then click on the Revolution Test box. You'll notice that it moves from under the Save Exceptions List tab over to the left side of the screen. Almost done. There are two more functions that we can set up for our scene. Auto Open Tabs, which automatically opens up tabs on student devices when the classroom session begins, and Maximum Tabs Allowed, which sets how many Chrome tabs a student can have during a classroom session. First, let's set the websites we just allowed to open automatically. In the Auto Open Tabs section, add the same three websites, one at a time, in the Enter Browser URL box. Now, in the Maximum Open Tabs section, click the Max Number of Tabs Allowed dropdown and select 3. Finally, click on the Save Scene button.